everyone, Felicity here today with a new layout today for hip kits using the April kit. Now, I was challenged to use the mood board for May, which is full of pastels and triangles and circles and stripes and a very pretty mood board created by Terry. Now, make sure you watch very, very closely, because this page takes a lot of twists and turns. It turns out absolutely nothing like how it is right now. It was just one of those pages where I wanted to use those acetate tags from the Pink Fresh Studio, and I wanted to use them right or wrong. And I've even go to the extent of sticking them down. I machine stitched through those triangles, which I use white cardstock for, to create, I guess, a bit more interest and patchwork underneath it because of the triangles that was on the mood board. So that pretty much was, or it is, the only thing that stays where it is. My layers underneath my photo stay, but I add to it later on why. It is just crazy how this came together. And believe it or not, this page actually took me a couple of days because I wanted to put in the bin, to be honest. I nearly did. I was like, no, don't be silly. Let's just work with it and challenge yourself and make it work. Make it into something that you enjoy. So I challenged myself, I took it up, and in the end, I liked what I did, but it did turn out quite busy for my liking. So I started to use some of the Vicky Booten crayons, which were in the colour kit. And yes, as you can see, I'm already getting frustrated because I'm like, why did I put that yellow down? Why did I do that? And I was just, what was I thinking? You know, it was just crazy. And I think it's near here soon that I just leave it and I walk away because I was already frustrated. So I pulled out some thread and I knew I had to do some hand stitching. I mean, no layer is complete without hand stitching, right? So I thought, well, that hand stitching might solve my problem. No. I can't even remember now if I actually hand stitched it, then pretty much demolished the page and nearly started again. I can't really remember what I did there. But as you can see, I'm physically sticking these down, and trust me, they don't stay. They get lifted up. And then I had to, when I changed my page around, of course it took a little bit of the cardstock to go, probably because I was frustrated, I didn't take my time too much and took them off, and then I had to try and then cover up that mess. Oh, what a show. Seriously, if you're a fly on the wall watching me do this page, you would have been in stitches, like literally. It was just, oh dear. Anywho, please tell me we've all done things like this before. And see, here we go. They're all gone already. Look, everything. And it was blue. Like, seriously. Now I have another challenge to not only cover up the paper that, or the little bit of glue that's still stuck on the cardstock, but I need to try and cover up most of that yellow because can you see my brain here? Oh my goodness. Somebody help. Oh, dear me. Right, so now what am I trying to do? Let's look. That's right. Now I'm starting to try and create a few layers underneath my photo. Let's take a look, because the end result again is not like this. Those little florals, tongue tie, are from the Project Life cards in the April Project Life kit. They were so cute. And they matched really, really well. So I fussy cut them out. And they do stay, but not where they are right now. So you can see I'm actually sticking my photo down. And I'm pretty sure I end up muting it as well. I actually was thinking of Just saying. Sorry, I don't have a video this time because it's so all over the shop. Everything changes, but then I thought, no, you might actually find it funny to watch how this comes together because it is rather amusing. Like, it really is. You've got to agree, huh? So a few of those other flowers I fussy cut from that crepe paper piece there that you can see in the left corner. I cut some of those out as well for more layers. And yeah, I'm still trying to work out. And yes, those triangle pieces in the corner, they do stay. And I do add a bit of hand stitching. And I do like them. Funny enough. These are some of the Vicky Booten stickers, which also came in the colour kit. They are designed to be used with the crayons, but I keep them black and white simply because I've got a black and white photo here as well. Now, I'm just going to get sidetracked here for a second. I want to ask you lovely people a question, proposed question, I suppose. I've had a couple of people say that my voiceovers don't come out as clear, perhaps, as they would like them to be. So I've been thinking for a little while that perhaps it's time for me to invest in a microphone to go over with the computer. Because I'm just using at the moment the computer's microphone, and that's probably half my problem. But I have no idea what to get. So those people that already do YouTube, do voiceovers, or are way more tech savvy than me, which, you know, that wouldn't be hard, can you please leave in the comments what you would recommend for me to use for a microphone, what you find works the best? I'm open for any suggestions or advice, I suppose, because, you know, I want to try and make these videos perhaps a little bit more enticing for you and a little bit easier for you to listen to. So if you can just let me know in the comments, I can then work towards getting a microphone for the computer, but I need your help. So if you can do that for me, that would be absolutely wonderful. Okay, back to the page. Right, what now? That's right. I'm adding in a few of those little sentiment stickers, which is from the Vicky Booten sticker page as well. And I do I end up colouring them? I do the arrow, you can see there with a bit of pink and red and a water brush. And I think I do the same, but I have a funny feeling that I end up taking them off too. I don't have the page right here in front of me, the finished page. And it is a little while ago since I did this page, so I can't completely remember. Because, surprise, surprise, I'm behind in doing my video editing voiceovers. That's just how it is. Anywho, these pink fresh, I think they're like a leatherette. They are so, so beautiful. But I'm absolutely loving the pink fresh collections at the moment. I think it's the colours, it's the ephemera, it's the stickers. I don't know. I'm really enjoying pink fresh at the moment. And I am tempted to buy a little bit, but not yet. I've got, like, at the moment I've just done another huge de-stash of scrap stuff that's just sitting here in my cupboard not being used, collecting dust, and I've just passed it on to some people that will treasure it and use it and love it. So at the moment, I'm not buying anything. Now, sticking more things down. Yes. But yes, please take note of how this is, because when you see the finished page, and I think I cut out a little bit towards the end here, because my video, seriously, if you were to watch this whole video, even with it sped up, I think it was like 20 minutes. So just imagine then how long that took me with breaks, looking after my children and so on. How long it actually took me to do this page? Like a long time. But hey, I did enjoy the process. I learned a lot from it. I did get more ideas from creating this page, and that's what I really enjoy, is I guess the inspiration that you can draw from simply creating your own pages. And that's one thing too that I'm really grateful for is HipKits. Not just the fact that you get to play with their kits every month, but the challenges that they put out to me, I suppose, because this mood board, I mean, it's not one that I would have just willingly gone and chosen to do. And because I was asked if I could do it, I was like, sure, I'll take the challenge up. So that's why I'm also very thankful for HipKits, because they push me, I guess, a little bit outside my creative comfort zone, which brings new inspiration, brings new ideas, brings new challenges, and I couldn't be more grateful for that, because I do enjoy challenging myself. I like to step outside sometimes my comfort zones. It's just good for me to simply do that. So I try to cover up, or working out how to cover up that yellow crayon underneath the photo and the pink. And you just shake your head at me, right? That's what you should do. And I do end up cutting out a big circle, because I went back to the mood board, I looked at the mood board, what inspiration can I draw from the mood board to be able to cover it up? And I use a circle because there's buttons, which are circular elements in the mood board. And the paper I use is black and white, and I hand stitch around it, and I add a couple more of the circles in as well. And I really liked how it ended up. So, win-win. yeah, here we go. Here's my circle. Look it up, people. Yellow be gone. Oh dear, I think it's time I had another coffee, hey? There we go, look. Doesn't that look much better? And then I end up moving the whole photo more up to the top left, where the big triangle is, so you actually end up seeing more of that circle. And it balances, the black and white paper balances out the black and white photo. It balances out the black and white hearts as well. So I was pretty happy. Yes, I was indeed. Okey-doke. I'm still trying to put more of these jelly triangles down. Oh dear. Yeah. Okay, I'm not sure of my direction here. So I think I end up soon walking away again. Or I might even wait till the next day. Because that's what you've got to do sometimes. If your page just simply isn't working like you think it should, you're getting stuck, you're getting frustrated, I suggest you just walk away or pack it up, put it away, bring it out in a couple of days with fresh eyes, and I can just about guarantee that something will come to you and you'll end up creating something that you do like. Trust me. That's what I did here. So, guys, I think I'm really at the end here. So, thank you for watching today my muddled, messy layout. please leave any comments below. I'm more than happy to see you next video.